better for us. Even in the business world, even in the business, my dad was a businessman. He went from a coal miner to a multi-million dollar business. And before he passed, you've got to find your baseline.
Absolutely.
You got to look and say, what exactly do I have here? I have a lot coming in, but I have a lot going out. What's the baseline? And I really believe with all my heart what you just said. You said the John 15 principle, because you cannot get, there's three levels of fruit. There's fruit, or, well, there's four actually, but it's not a level. But the first one's none. Then there's fruit, there's more fruit and much fruit. The much fruit is when he trims so that you can bear much fruit. And he said, these are the ones, he said, if my word abides in you and you and me. Yeah. See, a lot of people want to abide in God, but they don't want the word to abide in them.
True.
And so for the last 15 years, we've entertained, we've inspired, we've encouraged great things, but we're not back when I was a kid. I'm 46 years old, but back when I was a kid, I keep looking at you, not the camera. I apologize for the audience here. But back when I was a kid, we had Sunday school. We had Wednesday night Bible study. We got into the word. And, you know, God really shook me in this last season and said, get in the word, get your people in the word. Amos 8:11, it says there was a famine in the land and it was for the hearing of the word of the Lord. Mm. What happens right before God comes in revival form or the church is shaken or the church moves in power is they get full of the word of God. But Amos said, it's not a famine of the word of the Lord. He said, it's the famine of the hearing of the word of the Lord. You can go through any city in America and there's 500 churches, but if they're not preaching the straight truth word, and I think that's where we are right now. I think the famine is over. I think the shaking and the shifting is over. And the next season is the gathering. There's always three seasons, gathering, shaking, and shifting. And I really feel like the shifting is over. And people are now gathering, which is a huge buzzword in the Bible, Hebrews 10:25. Do not forsake the gathering, which is an infallible truth and a doctrine.
Absolutely.
Of which we as a church, through fear, through media, said, hey, we're not going to do that. We're not going to. But the devil's not afraid of a building. He's afraid of a gathering.